Amen, 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 amen. Welcome to our fourth session tonight. Thank you, technical team, for a wonderful music session. Indeed, what a challenge. That if God can use anybody, then what about me? Lord, use us, Lord. Thank you so much for that beautiful song. And want to welcome each and every one of you for being here tonight one more time, or maybe it is your first time. We want to welcome you if this is your very first time. And if this is your third or fourth time, we thank you for being consistent. And I know that if you're like me, you have truly been blessed to be here. And so we want to begin, and before we begin, I wanted to challenge those of us who are here. If you have been blessed to be here, can you put a Y or a one in the chat? Let's see those who feel that this has been valuable time for them. All right, I see that. Thank you, Al. I see that. Thank you. If you feel that you have, thank you, Darren, I see you, thank you so much. Oh, yes, yes, thank you, and thank you, everyone. I see that we have all been blessed, just like I have been. So without any further ado, I would like for us to begin with a word of prayer. Let us believe, even as we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your presence here with us. We thank you for the blessing of being able to gather in this manner so that we can fellowship and so that we can also hear your word spoken to us, Lord. And we thank you for the servants that you have used previously. You have used them in a very special way, and your word has touched our hearts. Father, we thank you for the blessing of your word. Thank you that your word is there for us to encourage us and to give us assurance and just to remind us that you will never leave us, nor will you ever forsake us. And when things are not exactly as we had planned them, that Father, you got it, you got it. Even though we do not understand the battle that we are in, that you got our back. So Father, we thank you that you're a God who takes care of those things that are impossible for us. Those things that we cannot do for ourselves, you are able to do them for us. And thank you for the reassurance that you give us, Lord, in the Lord Jesus Christ. And so Lord, even as we continue to linger at this place that has been a blessing to so many, that has blessed our souls, we pray that your Holy Spirit may minister to each and every one of us. For we recognize that we are all in different seasons. And Father, we pray that you may speak to the season that we are in right now. And so, Father, we bless everyone that is here, and that they may be blessed also as they hear your word. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Thank you very much. At this time, I would like to read our key text, which today comes from the book of Nehemiah, the book of Nehemiah. It is in the fourth chapter, Nehemiah, the fourth chapter, and it is we are going to read verse 10, and then we will jump to verse 20. All right, I hope you're there. Let me give you a second to get it. Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 10, and then verse 20. And here is the word of the God. Then Judah said, the strength of the laborers is failing, and there is so much rubbish that we are not able to build the wall. Then when we go to verse 20, it says, Wherever you hear the sound of the trumpet, rally to us there. Our God will fight for us. Wherever you hear the sound of the trumpet, rally to us there. Our God will fight for us. And so I want thank you, and may God bless his word. And so without any further ado, I would like to invite for us to hear the theme song. And then after the theme song, we shall have our guest speaker, our main speaker for tonight, Brother Jack Seme. Hear ye him. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. What a beautiful reminder that the battle is not ours. It belongs to the Lord. And that has been the theme of this week of prayer, a daily reminder that the battle belongs to the Lord. The battle belongs to the Lord. I hope that everyone here has had a blessed week so far, especially for those who have been able to follow this week of prayer. And I believe that it is, this week of prayer is a great source of encouragement to hear day after day that the battle belongs to the Lord. Today's subject that we will discuss in chapter 12's The Battle of Discouragement by Elizabeth Talbot. The title of chapter 12 is The Battle of Discouragement, and the book, The Battle Belongs to the Lord. When one of our elders, Mike, came to me with the subject for today, my first thought was, how ironic. And I say that to say that I believe that God really intended this message to be for me, if not for anyone else. But before we walk through this chapter, let's say a quick word of prayer. Heavenly Father, as I come before your people, let it be thee and not me. Let your voice be heard, and may we all be blessed. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so we will take some time to reread the verses that my brother read for us earlier, found in Nehemiah 4, verses 10 and verse 20. And it said, then the people of Judah began to complain, the workers are getting tired, and there's so much rubble to be moved, we will never be able to build the wall by ourselves. And Nehemiah 4:20, whenever you hear the sound of the trumpet, join us there. Our God will fight for us. Our God will fight for us. In the beginning of this chapter, Talbot starts off with the phrase, when circumstances are overwhelming, let God fight your battles. He will surely rescue you from distress and discouragement. So keep this in mind as we unpack the principles found in this chapter. And I would like us to discuss three points tonight. The power of prayer in times of distress, trusting God's timing and providence, and overcoming discouragement through faith and action. The personal testimony that Talbot shared about her personal battle with discouragement is one that I can honestly resonate with. She shared how the spirit of discouragement came upon her during a time when she was in an unfavorable situation in which she had no real control over. To briefly summarize, she was starting her PhD program at the University of Gloucestershire in United Kingdom. When she was there, she rented a room at the YMCA, and she expressed that she felt cold and unsafe. And she also shared that her books were very difficult, and the topic she had was one that was hard to follow. First, she said she was feeling overwhelmed by everything, by her living situation and her course of study for her PhD. And with that, she felt herself being swallowed by a black hole. And she expressed how her positive self-talk turned negative. And what was saying to her was, what am I doing here? There's no way I will ever be able to research this topic. I'm never going to make it. And I wonder how many of us, including myself, have ever felt this way. Have you been in a situation or are in a situation that just feels overwhelming? It could be work, family, health, school, whatever it is. It is something that has or is weighing down on us, and it feels like our spirit is being crushed under its pressure. I was trying to think of a specific experience that I could share, but I couldn't just pick one because the spirit of discouragement attempts to visit me often. And if I'm being honest, he stays longer than intended. And I personally, in the spirit of transparency, I personally struggle with negative self-talk, which means that at times I am my own source of discouragement. And as Talbot continued to share her experience, she expressed that the moment she felt utterly discouraged, all she could do was cry out to God for help. And she knew that God would give her the insight and strength that she needed in her moment of distress. And God did exactly that. And with that, it leads us into our first point, the power of prayer in the times of distress. When you get a chance, take some time to read through the full story of Nehemiah to see just how God moved on his behalf and the behalf of the people of Judah. Nehemiah tells us that he was a cupbearer for King Artaxerxes of Persia at that time. And when he received word about the state of his people in Judah, not only did he weep and mourn, his immediate response was prayer. He prayed for the forgiveness of his sins and the sins of his people, and also prayed for God's favor and guidance. Remember, when circumstances are overwhelming, let God fight your battles. He will surely rescue you from distress and discouragement. Nehemiah sets an example of what we need to do when faced with overwhelming situations, whether it's uncontrollable circumstances or self-inflicted circumstances. The first thing we need to do is take it to the Lord in prayer. Philippians 4:6 reminds us that we shouldn't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank him for all he has done. Now, let us imagine if Nehemiah reacted like we sometimes do and began to worry and contemplate how he can't do anything, or this is just too much for him. Do you believe that God would have had the fertile ground for which he could grow Nehemiah's faith? No, absolutely not. Well, let's think of worry, doubt, and anxiety as the things that rob the nutrients from the soil of our faith. On the opposite end, we can grow our faith by feeding the soil with daily spending time in God's word and in daily prayer with him. Nehemiah could trust in God's ability because he never forgot who God was. Even with him being in exile, he never forgot who God was. And that leads us to our second point, trusting God's timing and providence. Nehemiah's response to the news was immediate prayer, but God's answer to his prayer was not immediate. And that may seem like a tough pill for us to swallow, but the Bible reminds us that God's ways are not our own, and his thoughts are also not our own. And if I could add one more thing to that verse, it would be that his timing is not our own. In Nehemiah, we learn it was not until after 4 months of prayer and seeking after God did the opportunity rise for Nehemiah to make his request known to the king. And it so happened that it was the king that asked Nehemiah why his face was so downcast and that he seems troubled. And God orchestrated the king to be in favor of God, of Nehemiah's request, after explaining why he was deeply troubled. When the king asked Nehemiah what he wanted, before answering, what do you think Nehemiah did? He prayed again, and then made his request known. Nehemiah did not move without God in this situation. Yes, the king did grant the request, but it was because of God's providence. See, it would be a happy ending to say that Nehemiah was granted all that he asked for, and as soon as he got to Jerusalem, the building of the wall went smoothly without any issues or delay. Unfortunately, that's not what happened. When he got to Jerusalem, he was faced with different delays and obstacles there. And what this means for us is that many times in our walk with God, we will face delays, even for the things that we prayed years for. And in the event that we may not get what we have prayed for, the Bible reminds us that God's grace is sufficient. His grace is sufficient enough for us. Brothers and sisters, Nehemiah's story is reminding us to trust in God's timing. Yes, you have prayed for a better job, and the door has yet to be open. Trust in God's timing. Yes, you have prayed for a house, and the market is not favorable right now. Trust in God's timing. Yes, you have been and are still praying for your children. Trust in God's timing. Yes, you have been praying for God to restore your health, your marriage, your faith. Still, trust in God's timing. He was, is, and will always be faithful. God is never early nor late, but he is always on time. And that leads us into our final point, overcoming discouragement through faith and action. One of the challenges that Nehemiah faced when he got to Jerusalem was the discouragement of the people of Judah. They're saying that it was just too much work, too much rubble and debris, and that they could not complete the task by himself. He will also face opposition from neighboring nations who came to challenge and disrupt the work that God sent him to do. But see, instead of crumbling before these challenges and discouragement, Nehemiah remained steadfast in his faith and commitment to the task at hand. When the people began to become discouraged, Nehemiah encouraged them to remain focused on the greatness of God and the purpose in which they are working. When we are faced with challenges that can be overwhelming and discourage us, we need to remain faithful in who God is as opposed to what we are facing. And we can remember the words of Nehemiah spoke to the people of Judah, "Our God will fight for us." When other people came to discourage Nehemiah, he did not entertain them. Rather, he dismissed them and told them that he could not leave God's work and leave things undone. Talbot said something in this chapter that really stuck out to me. And it was, "You empower that which you give energy to. So choose wisely. Whatever you spend time thinking about, that will grow in your mind." Nehemiah chose to focus on God, his power, and his plans, not on the opponent's words, mockery, and threats. If any of you are like me and tend to give energy to negative self-talk, discouragement from others, or even myself, you'll soon find that you won't have much energy left to give because it will sap all that you have. Instead, choose to focus on God's power and his plans for our lives. And as I close, I want to read the quote that Talbot used from C.H. Spurgeon's book, The Two Guards, Praying and Watching. Nehemiah was well qualified for his work. He gave the Jews very shrewd, sensible, and yet spiritual advice. And this was great help for them in their hour of need. Beloved, we have a better leader than Nehemiah. We have our Lord Jesus Christ himself, and we have his Holy Spirit who dwells in us and shall be with us. The reality is that discouragement will find its way to everyone's doorstep in many different ways. Discouragement from ourselves, from our circumstances, and unfavorable situations in our lives. Though that may be true, no matter what we come to face, no matter what weapon is formed against us, remember that the battle belongs to the Lord, and never forget When circumstances are overwhelming, let God fight your battles. He will surely rescue you from distress and discouragement. May the Lord richly bless you.
Amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, and thank you so much, Brother Seme, for the powerful, powerful presentation of God's word. We thank you for allowing God to use you. What a blessing, indeed, that God, Jesus is always on time, never early, never late, just comes on time. And it is our timing that our impatience that tends to get in our way. And thank you for expounding on that word in a very powerful way. So with that, I would like to invite my brother, Elder Romelio Williams, to give us the closing prayer for today.
Let us pray. Gracious, loving, most kind, righteous, everlasting Father in heaven, O God. We are your children. We thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be part of your beautiful message, your business, your work. But Lord, we are not worthy. So God of love, please make us worthy, O God. We humble ourselves today and on the rest of our life, Father, that you, O God, would touch our heart, touch our mind, touch our understanding, O God. But most of all, forgive us for our sins, O God. We are falling short. But we pray, O God, that you will continue to let your light shine through us, that the world as a whole will see Jesus in us. As you hide us behind the cross, dear Lord, please continue to bless our families. Please bless our churches. Bless our pastors, oh God. Bless every member that come in between our churches. And oh God, give us the wisdom to just be loving and to be kind and to be understanding. Thank you again for the privilege, dear God. Please continue to bless these meetings, dear Lord. Let it touch the heart of those that doesn't know you, oh God. Bless and keep us, forgive us, oh God. Touch our hearts and our mind and on our understanding, dear Lord. Create in us clean hearts and renew a right spirit within us, oh God. And continue to allow us to be your children, dear God. And then when it's all said and done, great Savior, save us all in your kingdom, we pray. Not because we are worthy, we have done anything, oh God, to deserve your mercy and care, but because of what you have done on the cross, dear Lord. We love you, we worship you, and we adore you, my Lord. Save us, pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Elder William, for taking us to the Lord. And now I do have a very important request to all of us. Today we had 56 families that logged in to hear the word of God. Now, we need your help because you have testified that you are being blessed. And if it is true that we are being blessed, then let us not keep these valuable messages to ourselves. Our goal is 100. And tomorrow happens to be Friday. Many people are going to be home. And what a great opportunity for us to make sure that we each invite one. We will be 112 if we each bring at least one. How many would like to give that promise that they are going to invite? Yours is to invite, whether they come or not, at least you have given your best. Can you give a thumbs up? You're going to invite a few people, more than one. Thumbs up. If this is a deal we can make. Any promises? All right, I see some. Okay, all right, all right. Let's see the thumbs up if you are going to commit to at least invite and then allow the Holy Spirit to work on the invite. All right, thank you. Thank you, Darren. Thank you, Darren. Let me see. All right, thank you, Hope Community. Thank you. All right, anybody else committing to invite? All right. I know you're saying in your heart that you kindly help us get to 100 tomorrow. And with that, I would like to ask the technical team to give us the theme song as we close.
Fashioned against us will stand. The battle belongs to the Lord. We sing glory, honor, power and strength to the Lord. We sing glory, honor, power and strength to the like a flood. The battle belongs to the Lord. He's raised up a standard, the power of his blood. The battle belongs to the Lord. And we sing glory, honor, power and strength to the Lord. We sing glory, honor.
And amen.
Amen. And may the Lord bless you. Thank you for joining us tonight. As you can see, it is not a long session. We kindly request that you invite your friends. At the same time, 8 p.m. sharp tomorrow for another session. Thank you and God bless you. Good night.
Amen. Good night.
Good night.